students, today we are going to study the topic of the sentence. This is your first chapter in your book. We will study about sentence, different kinds of sentences, how we use them. All these we will study today. This sentence in Hindi we say vakya. Why do we use sentence and where do we use sentences? Sentences we use to communicate. हमें जब किसी से कम्युनिकेट करना है, वी वॉन्ट टू कन्वे अवर मैसेज और एक्सप्रेस अवर फीलिंग, इमोशन, थॉट, आइडिया, वी यूज डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ सेंटेंसेस. व्हेन वी कम्युनिकेट विद अदर पर्सन, वी फ्रेम डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ सेंटेंसेस अकॉर्डिंग टू अवर पर्पस और अवर नीड. हमें जब भी किसी से कम्युनिकेट करना है, कम्युनिकेट करना मीन्स अपनी बात या अपना मैसेज या अपना आइडिया या फीलिंग किसी को बतानी है, तो हम अलग अलग तरह के सेंटेंसेस को यूज करते हैं. दीज सेंटेंसेस आर अकॉर्डिंग टू अवर पर्पस. जो हमारी जरूरत है, नीड है या हमारा जो पर्पस है, उस अकॉर्डिंग हम डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ सेंटेंसेस को यूज करते हैं. द सेंटेंसेस कैन बी असर्टिव, इंट्रोगेटिव, इम्पैरेटिव और एक्सक्लेमेटरी. मेजर अगर हम डिविजन करें सेंटेंसेस की, तो हम मेजर पार्ट्स अगर हम सेंटेंस की करेंगे तो वी कैन डिवाइड दम इन फोर पार्ट्स. फर्स्ट इज assertive, second is interrogative, third is imperative and fourth one is exclamatory. Where do we use and how do we use and how do we structure them? Now, this we will study now. First type is assertive sentence. As we know, sentences are a group of words and they have some meaning in it and they give a complete meaning. So that's why we call them sentence. कोई भी ऐसा वाक्य जिसका अपना एक complete संपूर्ण अर्थ निकलता हो is called a sentence. तो सेंटेंस को जो हम यूज कर रहे हैं, तो हमारा अलग अलग पर्पस हो सकते हैं. सपोज वी वांट टू स्टेट समथिंग, हमें कोई चीज स्टेट करनी है, बतानी है, देन वी यूज असर्टिव सेंटेंसेस. असर्टिव टाइप ऑफ सेंटेंसेस वी यूज टू स्टेट समथिंग. द अदर नेम फॉर असर्टिव सेंटेंसेस स्टेटमेंट्स. हम उन्हें स्टेटमेंट्स भी बोलते हैं या स्टेटमेंट सेंटेंसेस भी बोलते हैं. असर्टिव सेंटेंसेस, द नॉर्मल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ असर्टिव सेंटेंसेस, देयर विल बी अ सब्जेक्ट. Then there will be a verb. After subject, there will be a verb and all other parts. As we know, sentences are divided into two parts. First is subject part and second part is predicate part. First will be the subject part and second will be the predicate part. Second part is the predicate part. In a sentence, predicate part, the verb is the most important or essential element. Agar sentence mein predicate part mein verb nahi hai, we cannot say that that is a sentence. वो sentence नहीं कहलाएगा. So most important or essential element for a sentence is a verb. एक verb एक sentence के लिए सबसे important और essential element होता है. So when we structure assertive type of sentence or you can say statement, normally the subject comes before verb. Normally subject क्या है? Predicate part से पहले आता है. But in some sentences you can find that subject comes after predicate. कि subject predicate के बाद में भी आ सकता है. And assertive sentence always ends with a full stop. The second type of sentence, suppose हमें कोई jumbled words मिले हैं and we have to structure an assertive sentence. First try to find out the meaning of that sentence. Words, those are given. Find out the meaning of those words and understand what type of sentence we want to, it is asked to structure. If it is assertive sentence, see the subject. Subject dekho kaun hai us sentence ka. If it is difficult to find out subject, then find out the verb. Aap verb find out kariye and ask the question of who and what by verb. Aap verb se who aur what ka question puchiye. The answer will always be a subject. To uska answer hamesha ek subject hoga. Okay? If I say she is reading. If I don't know what is the subject of this sentence, what is the verb? Is reading. So I will ask the question to verb, who is reading? Who is reading? The answer will be she. So she is subject. Who and what gives the answer for subject? Then second type of sentences are interrogative sentences. We use interrogative sentence when we want to know something or we want to ask something. When we ask something, we frame a sentence and those type of sentences are called interrogative sentences. These interrogative sentences have a different structure than assertive. As we see in assertive sentence, subject and verb, this will be the order of the word, of order of words. But in interrogative sentence, the structure is different. In interrogative sentence, the interrogative sentence begins with auxiliary verb. If there is any WH word in interrogative sentence, it will be before auxiliary verb, WH word, auxiliary verb plus subject, and if there is main verb, then all other verbs will be after subject, and it will end with an interrogative mark. So in assertive sentence, the structure is subject plus verb, and in interrogative sentence, the structure will be changed and the verb will come before subject. This is the major difference between the structure of assertive and interrogative sentences. Interrogative sentences can be of different types, but in your book, three types of interrogative sentences are given. First is yes-no type of questions. We frame yes-no type of questions when we want to know our answer in yes or no. It means हमने वो question क्यों frame किया है, क्या पूछना चाह रहे हैं, हम अपना answer yes या no में चाहते हैं. Then we frame yes or no type of interrogative sentences. These sentences begins with auxiliary verb. वो किसी ना किसी auxiliary verb से begin होंगे, and after that there will be a subject. And after that there will be a main verb plus all other things and end with question mark. At place of auxiliary verb there can be form of be, ki form हो सकती है, form of have or form of do or any model, कोई भी model हो सकता है. Anything auxiliary verb के place पर या तो be ki form हो सकती है, have हो सकता है, do ki form or models, इनमें से कुछ भी हो सकता है. And after that there will be a subject. Subject जो है, in assertive sentence normal structure is subject plus verb. But in interrogative sentences, the verb change its position, it will come before subject. वो subject के पहले आएगी. One type of question is yes-no type of question, it will begin with auxiliary verb. The second type of question is WH type of questions. In WH type of question, we structure them when we ask or want to know some more information. We do not want to answer in yes or no. We want to know some more information related, time, place, name, person, any information we want to know. We use WH word, and when we structure WH questions, we place WH word before auxiliary verb. Same structure we will follow, but the WH word will come before our verb. So auxiliary verb se pehle hum WH word ko place karte hain. The third type of interrogative sentences are question tags. For question tags, I made a separate video. You can see that video to understand question tags. Question tags are, in structure it seems like a question, but actually it's not a question. It is a question not to ask something, but to confirm something. We add that question tag with statement to confirm something. There is a separate video. You can see question tag related, all the important points in that video. Now we will discuss interrogative sentences in detail. We will learn how we will use different type of WH word and what are the rules to use them. First WH word we will see are who, whom and whose. These three WH word we use only for person. ये WH word जो है हम हमेशा persons के लिए use करते हैं. But more important thing, WH words are of three types. You can say interrogative words. WH interrogative words are of three types: interrogative pronoun, interrogative adjective, or interrogative adverb. Different type of WH words are there. Interrogative adjective means those WH words जो हमें adjective related answer देते हैं. And if I say the WH pronouns और interrogative pronouns, those WH words जो किसी noun के place पर आए हैं question पूछने के लिए, those are interrogative pronouns. And interrogative adverbs जो हमें adverbs related question पूछते हैं, we use them for asking question for adverb related answer will be there. It can be, we can ask question for time, place, manner, all these different type of WH word we can divide in three parts. See, first who, whom, whose. These are also interrogative words. These three interrogative words we always use for person. हम इनका use only person के लिए करते हैं. It means we do not use them for things. हम केवल person के लिए इनका use करेंगे. Next WH word is what. What we can use for person and thing both. हम what का use person और thing दोनों साथ कर सकते हैं. दोनों फॉर वी कैन यूज फॉर पर्सन एंड थिंग बोथ, दोनों के लिए हम इसका यूज कर सकते हैं. वन मोर इंट्रोगेटिव वर्ड दैट इज विच, विच ऑल्सो वी कैन यूज फॉर पर्सन एंड थिंग बोथ. हम पर्सन और थिंग दोनों के लिए यूज कर सकते हैं, बट हु होम हुज वी यूज ओनली फॉर पर्सन. हम इनका यूज केवल पर्सन के लिए करते हैं. वॉट वी कैन यूज फॉर पर्सन एंड थिंग बोथ एंड विच वी यूज फॉर पर्सन एंड थिंग बोथ. वन मोर इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग, वेन वी यूज डब्ल्यू एच वर्ड हु, वी यूज हु फॉर सब्जेक्ट ओनली. हम केवल सब्जेक्ट का क्वेश्चन करने के लिए कि एक्शन को करने वाला कौन है, फॉर दैट वी आस्क क्वेश्चन. Whom we, whom is the objective form? Whom जो है वो objective form है. And we use whom for framing question for object. And whose for possession. हमें possessive adjective का पता करना है, then we use whose. So in this way, the use of WH words are different from each other. We must be careful when we use these WH words. Next type of sentences are imperative sentences. Imperative sentences are sentences when we ask someone to do something. ऐसे sentences जहाँ पर हम किसी को कुछ काम करने के लिए कहते हैं. Suppose I ask, bring a glass of water, please. Bring a glass of water, please. This sentence, these type of sentences ends with full stop. And begins with verb. Imperative sentences. In imperative sentence, we ask someone to do something. हम किसी को कुछ करने के लिए कहते हैं. And we can ask someone in the form of command, or we can ask someone to do something by making request or order. These type of sentences are imperative sentences. What is the rule for it? They will always begin with the verb. वो हमेशा एक verb से start होंगे. So two types of sentences we learned that they will begin with verb. Interrogative sentence can begin with verb and imperative sentences also begins with verb. So in this sentence, tell me what is the subject in this sentence. Bring a glass of water, please. Who is the subject in this sentence? It is not written here, right? So in imperative sentence, we do not write the subject, but it is implied in it. And the subject of imperative sentences are always you. उनके सब्जेक्ट हमेशा यू होता है. वी डू नॉट राइट इट, बट इट इज इम्प्लाइड इन दिस टाइप ऑफ सेंटेंसेस. एंड वी यूज दिस टाइप ऑफ सेंटेंसेस फॉर कमांड, रिक्वेस्ट एंड ऑर्डर. द थर्ड टाइप ऑफ सेंटेंसेस आर एक्सक्लेमेटरी सेंटेंसेस. एक्सक्लेमेटरी सेंटेंसेस वी ऑलवेज एंड्स विद एन एक्सक्लेमेशन मार्क. एंड दे कैन बिगिन विद सम WH वर्ड लाइक वॉट एंड how we can use these words to frame exclamatory sentences. If we use WH word what for interrogative sentences also, and we can use the what for exclamatory sentence also. For example, if I say what a beautiful painting it is, what a beautiful painting it is, I am not asking, मैं आपसे कुछ पूछ नहीं रही हूँ. I am expressing my emotion. मैं अपनी एक strong feeling को express कर रही हूँ. कोई बहुत सुंदर painting मैंने देखी और मैं अपनी उस feeling को express कर रही हूँ. In this type of sentences also the structure is different. When we use what as in exclamatory sentence, first there will be what and after that there will be noun or noun phrase. हमेशा उसके बाद में what के बाद में noun या noun phrase आएगी. What a beautiful painting. A beautiful painting. This is a noun phrase. What a beautiful painting it is, and it will end with exclamatory mark. So exclamatory sentences we use for express our strong feeling and emotions. They are of different types. To wish someone also, हम किसी के लिए wish करते हैं, then also we use exclamatory sentence like may God bless you, and it ends with exclamation mark. So this was the introduction of different type of sentences. We will continue this chapter in our next video. Thank you, students.